Hey everyone, today I'm excited to show you 7 game-changing features in Windsurf AI that will tremendously improve how you work with your codebase. From setting smart AI rules and cleaning up dead code, to fixing build issues across multiple files simultaneously, we'll explore powerful features that make complex development tasks a breeze. The best part? I'll demonstrate everything using real-world examples from my own project. No theoretical stuff, just practical, hands-on solutions you can start using today. Let's get started. To ensure consistency, it's crucial to provide AI models with specific rules for our projects. This is where Cascade Memories comes in, a system that maintains context across conversations and lets you configure custom rules. Setting up AI rules in Windsurf is straightforward. Access Windsurf settings to find 2 options: global AI rules, applying to all workspaces, and workspace AI rules, specific to individual projects. The Edit Rules section provides various examples. You can set language preferences, like having the AI respond in Spanish, or specify technical requirements, such as your Next.js version. Pro tip, instead of writing these rules by hand, you can use Windsurf itself to generate them automatically. You might wonder, why add rules if Windsurf can analyze the project automatically? The answer is efficiency. Relying on Windsurf to determine this information with every request consumes more tokens and time. By defining these details in the rules upfront, Windsurf can skip the analysis step with each request. Let's see this in action by having Windsurf analyze our package and other configurations to determine our tech stack. This feature proves particularly valuable when working with rapidly evolving technologies like Next.js. Without specifying the version in our rules, the AI might get confused between Next.js 13, 14, or 15, leading to inconsistent responses. It also helps protect your code base against incompatible technologies. For instance, if you ask Windsurf about using Svelte in this project, it will acknowledge the possibility while warning about potential complexity. This demonstrates the true value of Windsurf's Cascade Memories. Next is Windsurf's Cascade, the main tool of Windsurf. Cascade comes in 2 modes, Write and Chat. Write mode allows Cascade to create and make modifications to your codebase, while Chat mode is optimized for questions around your codebase or general coding principles. Let's see the Edit mode in action by cleaning up our codebase. We have a home directory outside the main SRC directory. This is leftover from an AI dev tool I used to generate this project. It's common to have such leftover and unused files when working with AI dev tools. Cleaning these up is crucial because if we leave them and ask questions about our code base, they'll add noise to the context. The AI might touch these unused files and add unnecessary code, creating more clutter. This makes our code harder to understand and maintain. Let's ask Windsurf to check if this home directory and its files are dead code or still in use somewhere. We can't just delete it based on assumptions. It might still be used by other parts of our project. We need Windsurf to verify if it's truly unused before removing it. Once Windsurf determines the directory is unused, it will offer to execute a command to delete the entire folder. You can either allow or reject this action based on its analysis. In this case, Windsurf has confirmed the directory is indeed unused, so we can allow it to delete the folder for us. Pro tip, regularly clean your code base by removing dead code and unused files. It'll prevent major headaches down the road. Let's explore Windsurf's powerful multi-file editing feature. Since our project has some type errors, we'll use Windsurf to analyze the code base. In this project, I have set up linting, which is a code quality check that identifies potential errors, bugs, and style issues before the code runs. We'll execute npm lint and let Windsurf handle any type issues it discovers. What makes this special is that unlike traditional AI tools that work on single files, Windsurf can modify multiple files at once, and you can watch the changes happen live. The best part? You're always in control. Windsurf will ask for your approval on changes, whether for entire files or specific sections. While it tackles the remaining files, you can review and approve changes it has already made. You decide what stays and what goes, and Windsurf keeps working until every issue is fixed. Safety is built into the process. Before any commands run, you can inspect all updated files to verify that no errors remain. Pro tip, set up linting in your projects. It will make your code base more maintainable, minimize bugs, and help you take advantage of type systems like TypeScript. Windsurf can perform multi-line auto-completion. Combined with Cascade's real-time code awareness, This feature helps you complete tasks quickly and efficiently. For example, when I attempted to create a tutorial file for Git merging, I had the existing Git branch and Git basics files open along with the index file. Cascade easily understood what I was trying to achieve, even with simple prompts like continue. Our new Git merging tutorial was complete. Cascade generated the content with the right topic and complexity level based on the existing files in our codebase. It completed the task in one go without mistakes. This demonstrates the power of intelligently opening related files, even without explicit instructions. Pro tip, since Windsurf is aware of all opened files in the editor, it's important to close unrelated ones for maximum AI productivity. Windsurf offers precise control over file modifications through its inline command feature. This powerful capability allows you to selectively update specific sections of code while leaving the rest of the file untouched. For instance, when you notice the login form's email input text color isn't aligned with your current theme, you can target and modify just that particular section using an inline command, maintaining the integrity of surrounding code. What's particularly impressive about Windsurf is its contextual awareness and ability to identify related elements. When you initiate a change to fix the email input text color, Windsurf intelligently recognizes associated components, such as the password field, that should maintain visual consistency. Pro tip, make small, incremental changes to your code. This reduces bugs, simplifies debugging, and makes testing and rollbacks easier. Working with the terminal can be tricky, but Windsurf's inline commands make it much easier. You can simply tell Windsurf what you want to do using natural language. For example, instead of looking up specific Git commands, you can just say, rename the Git branch to Windsurf top features. Windsurf will generate the correct terminal command for you. While it's important to verify the commands before running them, experienced developers usually just need a quick reminder of the exact syntax. And if you're unsure, you can always ask Windsurf to show you the commands manual. Pro tip, save frequently used commands in a personal reference library organized by type with brief usage notes. Codelenses allow you to understand or refactor code with a single click. Let's test this feature. Say we need to understand a specific part of the code. We can use the explain Codelens action for that. Want to improve your code's maintainability? The refactor Codelens action makes it easy. Let's use it to make this code faster and more efficient. To add explanatory comments, there's the add docstring action. If the generated comments contain errors, don't worry. Windsurf has you covered. It immediately suggests fixes, and all you need to do is press tab. Pro tip, while refactoring improves your code base, always maintain a solid suite of unit tests. They'll ensure your changes don't break existing functionality. I'll dive deeper into this topic in future videos. Tired of manually allowing basic commands like git in Cascade? You can set default permissions by updating Windsurf's Cascade settings. Terminal commands can be automatically accepted or rejected through three configuration options. An allow list specifies terminal commands that will always auto-execute. A deny list specifies terminal commands that will never auto-execute. With auto-execution enabled, Cascade uses its judgment to determine if commands need user permission when they're not in either list. This feature requires premium models. If you found this walkthrough helpful, please hit that like button and subscribe for more AI development content. Share your thoughts in the comments. If you have questions about any of these features, want to see more practical examples, have discovered useful Windsurf tricks of your own. Thanks for watching. Happy coding!